Koffie. Welkom at Nerdiasm. We have here Bigos Pakketjes. Ooh. Whoa. Oh. They added the travel adapter. So I guess there is gonna be an adapter not suitable for Europe. So this is for a future video. It's all about this box. My previous vacuum cleaner was also a Dirt Devil and it was awesome. It was a really good vacuum cleaner and pretty cheap. This is a robotic vacuum cleaner, but one of the cheapest one that you can find. It was $59.95, but that's the discount price, so it's probably around 78. It's the Dirt Devil Spider M607, the Spider Robot Vacuum Cleaner. It's just a dumb vacuum cleaner. It's gonna bump somewhere and it's gonna go. It doesn't make blueprints of your living room. It doesn't have cameras or whatever. It's just gonna bump and drive off. 60 minutes runtime. It only has 7 centimeters high design. It's 1.5 kilograms, not that much. And it has a quarter of a liter volume of dust, 0.22. Suitable for hard floor, suitable for low pile carpets. I don't have carpets, so easy. Oh, it does a random pattern. And then a spiral mode, and then a perimeter pattern. Open it, dude! Replacement brushes. Oh, these are the batteries. These are 1000 milliamp hour 14.4 batteries. These are AA batteries, 1000 milliamp hour and 14.4 volts. Model B12-EO1 watt hours 14.4 watt hours. Only 1000 milliamp hours 15 volts. They shipped it short. And now the device. Ooh, more brushes. Ooh, shiny. Shiny, and then the bump. Oh, here you can see the dust collector. Oh, this is a replacement. This is a replacement filter. That's certainly not HEPA certified, but still it's a filter. That's not a lot of dust, but yeah, well, oh, and this is probably the motor. That's the intake. You can actually wash that filter. I think these are for higher carpets, but not so sure. And you should be able to just pull on the hairs and come off. Okay, it comes off. And then you can set the fall sensors. Position 0, like so. That's for light floors. That's for dark floors and shallow step doors. And they all have to be at the same setting. So position 1. Position 1. That's a little bit weird of a design. Those brushes reach those wheels, so they're gonna interfere with each other. That's extra wear and tear for no reason whatsoever. Let's put in those batteries. These are screws that I wanna know what's under here. Oh, that's the motors. That's the whole motor compartment. That's probably to clean out some dust or whatever. Or maybe for a cheap replacement of the motor. That would be actually nice. That you can repair your vacuum cleaner. So, the battery pack. That goes in the positive on that side, yes. We have placed the battery. Let's turn it on. Whoa! It doesn't drop. What? It's not that loud. Whoa. Okay. While my camera was acting up, I was playing a bit with this vacuum cleaner, and I kind of love it. It's pretty silent, it's not loud. It doesn't have a home docking where it goes to and it charges it, so it's completely autonomous. But it's not. You need to have to plug it in every single day of every so much time, and you need to turn it on and off yourself. So, those are the disadvantages, but do you want to pay a tenfold of this price? And the next thing I discovered during my camera hiccups is that it doesn't run. I can put it on. You have the red LED right there, and it stays in error phase, because hence the red LED. You can't run it without a lid on it, because there is a little switch for this little pin. So once we put that in, I'm gonna check the battery, and then it shuts off. So I need to cycle on and off. And there it goes. The first is the random pattern. Then it goes in a spiral mode, so it kinda wants to go right all the time. And then you have the perimeter pattern. It goes from this to this to this. So this is the first pattern, the second and the third. And it changes every 3 minutes. I'm gonna let it run for you for 9 minutes, but I'm gonna speed it up so it's only a couple of seconds of your life. Let's go. And it doesn't fall off the table. I don't need to stop it because of the sensors. Now it changed pattern. Now it changed patterns again. Now it's going crisscross. It stopped using the turn. Oh, it's going back to another pattern. It's back turning in to the left. Check that one out. It's pretty strong. Now that we've seen the patterns, there's not a lot of dust here on the table. Just a little bit of couple spickles. I wanna feel the suction power. Oh, it's upside down. It does feel that as well. Okay, here it goes. It doesn't wanna be upside down. Yeah, it sucks okay. It's not very great. These are some seeds, sesame seeds, and I want to sprinkle them all over the place and try a suction test. How well does it clean it, or does it gonna just spread it around? I hope it doesn't spread it around. I'm just gonna... Well, that's already a lot. I think that's a lot. Let's turn it on. I've seen a couple going on the floor, but only a couple. They're spreading a little bit. I think I seen 4, 5, 6, 7. There's still a couple, like a dozen. Yeah, and there only one left, two left. There's one there. Sometimes it just drops off the table. Check, it's off the table. That's bad. There's the last one, and it's gone. So not too shabby, not too bad. And here are the sesame seeds. Are that more or less than before? If you spread them out, somebody counts them. But overall, for 60 euros, this is working great! Guys, if you like this, give it a thumbs up. If you had something on this movie, please subscribe. I thank you for watching and I see you guys the next time. It's probably gonna be a power bank, but I don't know. Bye. I'm turning it on. And there it goes. It's quite silent. It's gonna be out of focus, I'm not gonna change the focus. Indicator, battery indicator, continuously red. And then it thinks it's not in the on the floor. I'm just gonna restart. I do think the battery is flat though. I didn't charge it yet. So maybe I should do that first. Okay, I'm gonna shut it off. We've seen enough. We've seen all the three cycles and stuff. These are some Sesame Streets. That's for the bloopers. These are some...